Hello, everyone. This is Dr. Wang. What is the question here? How many positive integer solutions for this equation, x plus y plus z equals 7? Positive integer solutions, that means all x, y, z values must be positive integers, cannot be 0. First, we solve this problem for non-negative solutions. What does that mean? That means x, y, z values can be 0, but not negative. All are integers. We use a trick called sticks and stones. We use two sticks to divide 7 stones into 3 groups. Example. We have 7 stones here and 2 sticks. Now 2 sticks divide 7 stones into 3 groups. On the left-hand side of first stick, this number of stones here, that's x value. Number of stones in between the two sticks, that's a value for y. Number of stones on the right-hand side of the second stick, that's a z value. So the corresponding solution is x equals 1. Yes, 1 stone here. Y equals 4 here. 4 stones in between. And z equals 2. 2 stones on the right-hand side of this stick. Look at another example. So here, x value, that's 2. But we don't have any stone in between the two sticks. What does this mean? This means y equals 0. We have nothing here. So z value equals 5. The corresponding solution, that's x equals 2, y equals 0, z equals 5. The question here is, how many arrangements of 2 sticks and 7 stones? Look at, put them in this order. So here, this is also a permutation problem. So permutations of similar objects. Total number of objects, we have 2 sticks and 7 stones. Put them online. That's 9. 2 types of objects, sticks and stones. So the formula to calculate the total arrangement, total permutations is this. 9, that's the total number of objects. Here, 2 factorial, what does that mean? This is the first type of objects, that's a stick. How many there are? 2, that's 2 factorial. This is a second type of objects, that's stones. How many? 7. So simplify this, we have here. So what is the factorial mean? 9 factorial means 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 and so on. The last one is times 1. Similar here, 2 factorial is 2 times 1. 7 factorial is 7 times 6. Then simplified, we have the answer is 36. So here, 36 is the solution for the equation. X plus Y plus Z equals 7. But here, the condition is non-negative solutions. From example, we can see X can be zero, Y can be zero, Z can be zero. But in the original problem, we need positive integer solution. X, Y, Z cannot be zero. So now how to do this? Practically, we can do this. Because X, Y, Z from previous example, they can be zero. How to avoid zeros? We can do this. Save one stone for each X, Y, Z. That means give X one stone. Give Y one stone, give Z one stone. So totally we have seven stones. After we did this, how many stones left? We only have 7 minus 3 left, 4. So here we solve this. X plus Y plus Z equals 4. 4 is 7 minus 3. So solve this equation, repeat the same method. We can find X, Y, Z, how many ways, right? So here X can be zero, but you only have one at hand. If it is zero, then X equals zero, then actually X is one. If Y is two, actually Y is three, right? So here, solve this equation. Total items, that's 2 plus 4, not 7, right? 7, we already saved the 3 there. So that's 4. So here, that's 2 factorial, that's 4 factorial. Simplify, we get 15. 15 is the final answer. That's all. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.